What is up, guys? This is Josh the Gamer here, coming at you with a brand new video. So today we are going to be starting a brand new series. This series is going to be excuse me. This series is going to be a series on the Quorum programming language. Now, in this series, I'm going to assume that you have the NetBeans IDE installed. I'm going to assume that you have the Java Development Kit installed. And I'm going to expect that you have the Quorum plugin for NetBeans installed already. Alright, so let's get started with this, shall we? Now, however, there is going to be a link in the video description to the Quorum programming language page, downloads page, where it will give you detailed instructions on how to install the Quorum plugin into NetBeans if you don't know how. So, without further ado, let's go ahead and start. First off, we need to create a new project. So let's go ahead and we're gonna go up to the top of the NetBeans window and find the New Project button. When you click on New Project, there should be a pop-up window that pops up. You'll be given many options, such as Gradle, if you have the Gradle stuff installed, Java, JavaFX, Maven, Groovy, all this other stuff. You're going to want Quorum. You're going to want to click on Quorum, which should be the first or second option, I would imagine. Then you're going to be given four different types here. You're going to be given application, Lego application, game application, or blank application. Right now, we're going to do blank application. Now you're going to be given a prompt to set a project name, a project location, which I recommend keeping the same, and then project folder, which you cannot edit. So I'm gonna rename my project to tutorials. All right. Okay, so apparently I already have a folder of that existing, so I'm going to go ahead and just put Quorum at the end of it. There we go. Let's go ahead and hit finish. And then it's going to start creating the project, and now you should have the project. In the sidebar in the projects pane, go ahead and find tutorials, Quorum, or whatever you named your project. Open that up. You'll find a folder called source code. Open that folder up. Then you'll find a file called main.quorum. This file is essentially the file where you do all your Quorum programming in. Now let's see here. Okay, it's giving me an error at the beginning, but hey, sometimes it does that. All right, so now to the point of this tutorial. This first tutorial is going to be about the different variable types in Quorum. Alright, so there's going to be different types of variables that you're going to want to do, some of which are for GUIs, some of which are for games and graphics and all this other cool stuff, but however, those are not the main types to a programming language. We're going to be learning the main types of a programming language that you would most of the time use in a real-time application. So first off, we're going to learn the int variable, the integer. Now, when you're in your edit field, or when your code editor is in focus, go ahead and type integer. Now that should glow blue. If you're using visual, it should be blue. If you typed integer correctly, you should. I don't know what kind of prompt it gives you, but you should be able to figure out if you've gotten it right. Now an integer is essentially a whole number. It does not have decimal points or fractions or anything. It's just a whole number, such as 1, negative 1, 0, 2, 3, so on and so forth. So we're going to go ahead and call this, we're going to call this Quorum version, just for simplicity. And then we're going to do space equals 4. All right, because we're doing this with Quorum 4.0, okay? Quorum 4 is the newest version of Quorum, so this is not going to be out of date until next summer. Well, at least the majority of this information stays the same. However, some things will be added, some things can be changed, you never know. All right, so anyways, when you're creating your variable, this brings me to the first syntax. This brings me to a good convention with Quorum. Now, when you're creating variable names in Quorum, you're going to want to do camel case. What is camel case? Well, camel case is essentially where in the first word of your variable, if your variable has more than one word in it, okay, the first letter of the first word has a lowercase, and then anything after that, the first letter of every other word after that, has a capital letter. That is camel case. Now, when we get into actions and stuff, and classes and all this other stuff, it'll be a little bit different. But you'll find out what actions and classes are later in the tutorials. But right now, we're just going to focus on variables. So, with an integer variable, or with variables in Quorum, you need to initialize a value immediately after you create the variable. Otherwise, it will give you an error. So what I did here was I deleted the equals 4 and went to a new line. Now, it'll give me an error saying, I noticed that the variable Quorum version has the declared type of integer, but the right-hand side of the statement was blank. So it'll give you an error, and it won't let it slide. So you need to give it a value immediately. So say you wanted to change it later in the program, you would just do equals 0. And it'll allow you to change it later in the program. You'll have no problem. You'll have no problem doing that. So, now another thing with variables is you even have different modifiers for the variables. You can do public, private, stuff like that, but I believe it's only public and private. So, if you wanted your integer to be accessible from other Quorum files in your project, you can just do public. You can just add the public modifier, and it'll make it a public variable, so you can access it from another file. However, if you want it to be a private variable, you just add the private keyword. However, the private keyword is not even required, because when you just type integer alone, that automatically makes it a private variable, which is actually pretty cool. Now that we're done discussing what an integer is and different things you can do with variables, we're going to do another variable type. This one is going to be called number, or in other programming languages, it's known as a double. Now, what is a number or double? It's essentially a numerical value that has a fraction or decimal point in the value. So let's go ahead and say number on a new, and this is on a new line, and then we're gonna call this Quorum version again. Equals 4.0. Okay, so I cannot name this Quorum version, because there's already a variable with that name. So I'm going to call this Quorum version decimal. And it's and then I set the value to 4.0. And it will accept that. And if I, say if I wanted to do 4.5 or 4.4 or 4.3, so on and so forth, it'll allow me to do that. Why? Because it's a number. It will allow for the decimal points and fractions in the value. Now, the last two variables have nothing to do with numbers. Okay? The next variable type is called text. Now, this variable type in other languages is also known as a string. And what a string or the text variable type is, it's essentially it's essentially just text. And however, you have to put it inside of quotation marks. All right, so let's go ahead and type text. We're gonna call it, test text. And we're gonna set this equal to a value of programming is fun. All right. Now, one of the cool things that I'm sure you've already noticed is that I have not said at any time to put in a semicolon. You don't need a semicolon with Quorum. In fact, if you even try to put a semicolon, it'll give you an error. Because semicolons are not in the syntax of the Quorum programming language. Other programming languages require almost every other programming language requires you to use a semicolon, and where to put semicolons can get very confusing, and you'll get a lot of errors that way. However, with Quorum, you don't need them. It automatically knows when a statement ends, which is really nice. That's one of the cool things that I really like about Quorum. Okay, so now, once you have your text variable created and your value assigned, if you have an error, go back through the value of the variable, because that's more than likely where you're going to have it, and make sure that your value is surrounded with opening and closing quotation marks. All right? So that is essentially how you create a... That's essentially how you create a text variable. Now the next one is a very useful variable type. It only has two possible values, true and false. This is known as a Boolean value, or this is known as a Boolean. Now a Boolean is essentially a value that determines whether something is true or false, on or off, so on and so forth. Boolean values are seen a lot in electronics, especially with Boolean circuits in digital electronics. But that's a whole different story for another time. Let's go ahead and create a Boolean. So just type Boolean, B-O-O-L-E-A-N. We're going to name this Quorum Active. And we're gonna set this equal to true. Why? Because we are using Quorum right now, so it is active. And since we set it to true, we don't get an error. However, if we were to set it to any other value, such as text, it won't do it. It'll give us an error. If we set it to a number value, it'll give us an error. We want it to either be true or false, so I'm going to set it to true. Those are the four essential variable types that you're going to need integer, number, text, and Boolean. These are very important variable types in the in programming in general. They're not always going to be named the same as Quorum names them, but the concept is essentially the same. All right, so that pretty much concludes my tutorial on how on the different variable types of in the Quorum programming language. Thank you all for watching, and we will see you all in the next tutorial.